Now we are going to study numerical integration. For a function y is equal to fx, fx is not known explicitly. Means we have a function y is equal to fx and we don't know about the fx in terms of a function. The data points x0, y0, x1, y1, x2, y2 and so on, xn, yn are given. It means we are given only points, the points x points and the corresponding y points, but not the function. We need to compute the definite integral I is equal to integration from a to b y dx. So here we don't know about y means fx. Here we replace y is equal to fx by an interpolating polynomial phi x and obtain an approximate value of I in equation 1. Since we don't know y explicitly, so we can get the approximate solution. There exist so many different integration formulae. In general, the general formula for numerical integration is given below. We will use this formula for numerical integration. See, integration from x0 to xn y dx is written as n into h within bracket y0 plus n by 2. This is your forward difference operator on y0 plus n into 2n minus 3 by 12. Second order forward difference operator on y0 plus n minus 2 whole square by 24. Third order forward difference operator on y0 plus so on. For this purpose, we used Newton's forward difference formula. In our study of Newton's forward difference method, we have seen this formula. So we will use this formula. Here the interval AB. See the interval AB. This is divided into n equal subintervals such that A is your x0 and B is your xn and intermediate points are x1, x2 and so on, xn minus 1. These are your intermediate points. So xn is equal to x0 plus nh. First forward difference operator on y0 will be given as y1 minus y0. We have studied earlier. And second order on y0 is first order forward difference on y1 minus first order forward difference on y0. So its value comes out to be y2 minus 2y1 plus y0. Now we will study formulae due to trapezoidal, due to Simpsons, due to Boole's, and there is midpoint rule also. So first see trapezoidal rule. We will study its composite part also. Composite part means a general formula using trapezoidal rule. For n is equal to 1 in equation 2, you have earlier seen this is your equation 2. Here substitute n is equal to 1 and delete all these terms of forward difference operator of order greater than or equal to 2. Since therefore we will stick only this up to this term y0 plus n by 2 forward difference on y0 and neglect all differences higher than the first. So we will neglect all differences higher than the first. So you can see the equation, your equation 2 will come out to be integration from x0 to x1 y dx is equal to n is equal to 1. So it is 1 into h within bracket y0 plus n by 2 means 1 by 2 into forward difference on y0. So this is h into y0 plus 1 by 2. This is your y1 minus y0 and its value comes out to be h by 2 into y0 plus y1. This is your trapezoidal rule for n is equal to 1. And now we proceed on for x1, for the interval x1, x2. So it will be integration from x1 to x2 y dx is equal to h by 2 within bracket y1 plus y2. And for the interval x2, x3, integration from x2 to x3 y dx is h by 2 within bracket y2 plus y3 and so on. for the interval x n minus 1 x n, we have integration from x n minus 1 to x n y dx is h by 2 y n minus 1 plus y n. Now add all these, all of them we add. Combining all these, we get integration from x0 to x n y dx is equal to integration from x0 to x n x1 y dx plus integration from x1 to x2 y dx plus 1 plus integration from xn minus 1 to xn y dx. Substitute the values. So you will get this is equal to h by 2 y0 plus 2 into y1 plus y2 plus 1 plus yn minus 1 plus yn. So this is your known as trapezoidal rule in composite case or composite trapezoidal rule. This is known as composite trapezoidal rule. Now see, there are some notes. The curve y is good fx is replaced by n straight lines joining the points x0, y0 and x1, y1. This is your first straight line. Second, joining the points x1, y1 and x2, y2 and so on, joining the point xn minus 1, yn, n minus 1 and xn, yn. The area bounded by the curve y is equal to fx, the ordinates x is equal to x0 and x is equal to xn means perpendicular on the x-axis, and the x-axis is then approximately equivalent to the sum of the areas of the n trapeziums obtained. Since we get a figure of a trapezium, that is why this rule is known as trapezoidal rule. Now we can see we have examples on this trapezoidal rule. Let us see some of them. The problem is that, example, evaluate integration from 0 to pi t into sin t dt using the trapezoidal rule. You will get this type of problem in your examinations. Let us see its solution. Here we will take h is equal to pi by 4. We can take any other value of h. Then n into h will be b minus a equal to b minus a. This is the formula. And so n into h means pi by 4 is equal to b. B is your pi and a is your is 0. So this is pi minus 0. From this we get n is equal to 4. And ft is your t sin t. So now substitute the, write the, evaluate the values of t and ft. For t is equal to 0, substitute t is equal to 0, then you will get ft is equal to 0. For t is equal to pi by 4, if you substitute t is equal to pi by 4, then from this formula ft will be pi by 4 root 2. For t is equal to pi by 2, sin pi by 2 is 1, and this is your pi by 2, so this is pi by 2. For t is equal to 3 pi by 4, ft will be 3 pi by 4 root 2, and for t is equal to pi, the sin pi is 0, so ft will be 0. So in this way, you can make this table having the values of t and ft. Now apply the trapezoidal rule. The trapezoidal rule gives the formula. Integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to, just write the formula, h by 2 within bracket y0 plus 2 into within a small bracket y1 plus y2 plus 1 plus yn minus 1 plus yn, bracket close. See here, y0 is your 0 and yn is your 0, and these three are y1, y2 and y3. So integration I is equal to integration from 0 to pi t sin t dt. It will be h by 2 means h is your pi by 4 by 2, and this y0 is your 0. See here, y0 is 0 plus 2 into y1. This y1 is pi by 4 root 2, and y2, y2 means this pi by 2, and y3, y3 means this 3 pi by 4 root 2, and this is your y4, and y4 is your 0. Now you can very easily evaluate this one. 2, 2 cancels each other, pi by 4. The sum of these three is pi by root 2 plus pi by 2. Take pi common, so it will be pi square by 4 into 2 root 2 within bracket 2 plus root 2. So take root 2 common, so this is equal to pi square by 8 under root 2 plus 1. So this is the value of this integration from 0 to pi t sin t dt using the trapezoidal rule. You can very easily evaluate. There is another example. See, Example is integration from minus 2 to 2 t by 5 plus 2t dt. You need to evaluate this one using trapezoidal rule. So you just write the values of ft. Ft will be t by 5 plus 2t. And take h is equal to 1. You can take any other value of h also. Then n will be b minus a by h. Means b is your plus 2 and a is your minus 2. So this is 2 minus minus 2 by h means 1. So this is your 4. Means the value of n comes out to be 4. So we will have the values of t as minus 2 and the h is your 1. So minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. So we have 5 values of t and evaluate the corresponding values of ft using this formula. So in this way, you can evaluate this integral very easily. So after this, we will study. We have one more example. You can see this example also. We have some time. See here. This says find the area bounded by the curves and the x-axis from x is equal to 7.47 to x is equal to 7.52 for the table. This is the table. And in the first row, we have the values of x. And in the second table, we have the corresponding values of y. See here, the values of x are equidistant, 7.47, 7.48 means 0.01, difference of 0.01, 7.49, 7.50, 7.51, 7.52 means they are equidistant and the corresponding values of fx. See solution, since area is given as integration from x0 to xn y dx, this is the formula for area. So this is integration from 7.47 to 7.52 fx dx. Why? Because the minimum value of x is 7.47, maximum is 7.52, this is given. And h is your 0.01. So from trapezoidal rule, we know that area is given as h by 2, y0 plus 2 into y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus y4 plus y5. See here, this is y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, and y5. So you can very easily evaluate this one. Only you need to substitute all the values. So this is equal to 0.01 by 2 is in bracket y0. Y0 means 1.93 plus 2 into y1 means 1.95. y2 1 plus 1.98. y3 2.01. y4 2.03. And y5 is your 2.06. So this value comes out to be 0.0996. There is another example for you to practice. After this, we will go to simple 1 by 3 rule. But in your next class, till then you just note down all of them and take a screenshot also. This lecture will be available on YouTube, my YouTube channel. You just watch YouTube channel and there is a comment section. If you have any difficulty, you just message me here and type your comments in the comment section.